You are welcome to SUSEM Academy. Today we are going to take a look at biology, and the topic is organization of life. Organization of life. Okay, we in our previous lecture we introduced the concept of what biology is all about, and we came down to classifications of living things, and we also distinguish between living organisms and non-living organisms. We also came down to plants, distinguish between plants, the difference between plants and what? Animals. And we also went down to classification, trying to we talk about the main five phyla we have in living organisms. We started with Monera, Protista. We came down to fungi, then plantae and animale. Now we are going into the organization of life. You know. Now, living organisms. You know, we said life because we are now talking about what living what organisms. Now, the living organisms is highly organized. It's highly what? Organized. Nature made it that way. It's highly what? Organized. So we are going to look at this organization. Let's see how organized living organism is. Now, based on this now, we have to go down to the levels. Because when you talk about organization, there must be what? Hierarchy. Level. Each time you mention organizations, that something is organized, that means there are levels. From the lowest level, building up on top the lowest level. And the adding, because as you are building up on top of the, from the smallest level to the higher level, as you are building up, other new features or characteristics are being what added. So what you are seeing at the higher level will not be the same thing you saw or you have in the world lower level. So as the level increases, you now see different features, added values. Now, based on that, I'm going to do a sketch of something on the board. Remember, our reference book today is Modern Biology for Senior Secondary Schools, revised edition 2018 by Sarojini T. Ramalingam. Now, let's continue. Here we have, starting from the lowest, I'll start from the lowest to the highest. Now we have macromolecules. Give me a number, this one is not writing well. Macromolecules. Then above macromolecules we have organelles. Above organelles, we have cells. Above cells, we have tissue, or tissues as the case may be. Above tissue, we have organ. Above organ, we have organ systems, or simply systems. Above organ system, we now have what? Organism. And going into living organism, watch. Each of these levels, they have organism that that stopped at each of this level because of their composition of because of what they are composed of. They stopped some organisms stopped at particular higher at particular levels of this hierarchy. Some stop at this level. Some stop at this level. Some stop at this level. Some stop here. Why some get up to this level? Are we there? Now, we talk about this hierarchy. We talk about the component, what each of this is composed of, and representative organisms that stop at each of the world level. With this, we would have done justice to what? Organizations of what? Life. With this, we would have done justice to what? Organization of what? Life. Now, before I continue, when we talk about life, remember we are here now. This is I want to do things. I want to use this hierarchy now to describe organisms in general. Organisms in what? General, not just only what? Living one. Either. Now let's go. From here, macromolecules, they are non-living. True of us. They are what? Non-living. Organelles, they are what? Non-what? Living. But from cells, life starts. Cell is what? Living. From cell down to what? Organism. This is multicellular organisms. Multi what? It's multicellular organism. They are what? Living. From here down are what? Living. Now, what are the macromolecules? What are they? Macromolecules are composed of atoms and molecules. Atoms are what? Molecules. Examples are, we have here enzymes. Enzymes are here. RNA is here. Even DNA is what? Here. Even though they are non-living, but interaction between them give rise to what? Organelles, which are still non-living, but higher than them. And in interactions, watch. Interaction, even though organelles are non-living. Remember, I said that everything is what? Chemistry. I'm saying now. Everything is what? Chemistry. Life starts from where? Chemistry. Still, come down to what? Atom. You can't talk of atom without talking about what? Chemistry. Have you seen now? Atoms, these things are, even though all this DNA, RNA, they are made up of what? Different atoms. If you go down, break it down, they are atoms. Because macromolecules to molecules, atoms, still come down to matter. Does it make sense? So when I say that everything is chemistry, I mean it. Now, as you can see, now even though macromolecules are non-living, but their interaction gave rise to the functions, what we call what? Organelles. That organelles are functioning is based on the functions of this what? Macro what? Molecules. At the same time, even though organelles are still non-living, their interaction between organelles, among organelles, gave rise to the functions of the what? Cells. But at this point now, something new is now added. And at this level of cells now, it becomes what? Living. But the cells, without the interactions among these organelles, they will not be like what? Cells. Have you ever seen a cell without organelles? Is that what a cell? Have you seen it now? Even though they are not living, but their interactions give rise to the functions of what? Cells. At this point now, it's now what? Living. The same way, interactions of different cells, or similar cells with the same structural and function, give rise to the function of the what? Tissue. And interactions among different tissues give rise to what we call what? Organs. The same thing, organ system and the multicellular full organisms. This is where we, the level where human beings are, and mammal, or in other words, mammals, and other higher organisms. Now, do you now understand what I mean by the interaction? The interaction between the lower, the component of a particular level, give rise to the functions of the next upper level. An interaction between them again give rise to the. Have you not seen what such interaction has led to? Migration from non-living to what? Living. Is it not wonderful? How can you explain it? These things are non-living things. But their interaction gave rise to what? Living. From there to here. Now, let's go there. The two organelles are composed of. Okay, each one I pick, I will say which organisms. Are you there? At this level now, there is nothing here. Now, here, organelles. Organelles are composed of molecules and what? Macro what? Molecules. Molecules are what? Macro what? Molecules. Here, virus is at this level. Virus is where? At this level. Now, let us look into it. What is the component of virus? Is nothing but what? This either RNA or DNA enclosed in protein what? Coats. RNA, either RNA or DNA. They are also, RNA and DNA, are they macromolecules or more molecules? Now enclosed in protein coat. Protein, is it macromolecules or molecules? Macro. I don't see why I say that. It's composed of what? The same thing with virus as an organism, even though it's not living outside, it's not living, but living. Because this is what will now make you realize why we say that virus, if it is outside, it's not living. But if it is inside, if it is outside, it contains just either DNA or RNA in enclosed in protein what coat. Outside is nothing. It's not living. Nothing. But once they gain access into the body, what happened is this. This interaction that gives rise to this becoming living thing will take place. Are you there? Replication, transcription, and what have you will start to taking place. And at the end, what you will notice is that the virus will now make use of the genome of this cell and start replicating. So the interaction now will make it to start behaving like what? Living what? Organism. So that is exactly what happens when you get so at this level, virus is representative at this level. Now, if you go down to cells, what are cells? Cell can be defined as what? The basic functional and structural unit of what? Life. Basic functional and structural unit of what? Life. That's cell. Now, at this point now, life does what? Begins. From here is living. Now,
So that means cells is composed of what and what? Look up. Cell is composed of what? Macromolecules and what? Macromolecules and what? Organelles. Cell is composed of macromolecules and what? Organelles. Now, at this level, give me an example of organism at this level. Give me plants, give me animal.
Chlamydomonas.
Okay, now let me just mention their classes. At this level, now we have Moneras are at this level. Bacteria, and what are you? Two of us. Protista at this level. You have your what? Protozoas and protophytes. Protophytes are there. Protozoa, you have your what? Amoeba. Are you there? Paramecium, two of us. Then, for the fighters, now you start having you are Chlamydomonas and what have you. Two of us. Iguana is in between, two of us. It has plant-like and animal-like. So, but the summary is that these animals that are unicellular are at this level. Organism. Now, part of the complex organism. So, part of their body that are at this level, we that's this way we start talking about the cells. The cells of the what? Body. This is where we start talking about what? The cells of the what? Body. At this level now, this is where you start talking about the red blood cells. Red blood what? Cells. Red blood cells. I'm giving example of cells. I'm giving you cells as a complete organism on its own. As an independent organism on its own. That's where you have the unicellular what? Organisms I mentioned. Now, cell within the body. Here now we start having in animals. Here now we start having what? The red blood cells. And what are the functions of the red blood cells? Red blood cells convert what? Blood or oxygen.
Oxygen from the...
They contain what you call what? Hemoglobin. That combine with what? Oxygen to form what? Oxygen what? Hemoglobin. In summary, they convert oxygen and nutrients, not only oxygen alone. Oxygen and what? Nutrients to different parts of the body. Oxygen and nutrients to different parts of the what? Body. Three of us. Because we need oxygen for what? Remember when we talk about respiration, we need oxygen and for what? Respiration. Oxygen is needed to break down those nutrients. Three of us. When you break down those nutrients, at the cellular level, what happens? Energy is what? Released. And this energy is what the cell uses to drive its processes. So without this energy released, the cell will do what? Not survive. And if the cell fails to survive, the entire organism is what? Is as good as what? Dead. True of us? Good. Now, that is red blood. Have you not seen what? At this level, now, the cells in the system, we have red blood cells. And that cell, another type of cell, we also have white blood cells. White blood what? Cells. What do white blood cells do? White blood cells are there to protect the body against what? Disease. Are you there? They form part of the what? Immune system. Two of us. Why red blood cells? Watch now. Red blood cell is part of a system called what? Secretory system. Moving nutrient and oxygen. Now, white blood cell is now part of system called what? Immune what? System. Protecting the body against what? Diseases. Is God not wonderful? Now, let's also look at another type of cell. We also have nerve cells. Nerve cells. Nerve cells, they are there to do what? Transmit what? Impulses. They transmit what? Impulses. Remember when we discuss the characteristics of what? Living things. We talked about sensitivity, sensitivity or irritability in animals, especially in high organisms, where we have nerve cells. This sensitivity is being conducted by what? The nerve. And the nerve is a tissue. This nerve being a tissue has cells. We call what? Nerve cells. What's another name for nerve cells? Have you heard of neurons? Can we call neurons nerve cells? Yes, neurons. Now, so have you not seen neurons, nerve cells, nerve as a tissue, then nervous system as a system? Have you not seen how the thing is going? From the cells now, neuron, nerve tissue, nervous system that conduct what? Impulses. Three of us now, all these nerves in the body, different part of the body, the what informs a lot of changes in your system may be that even without nerve, can you move? You cannot move. That's why I said that he is paralyzed. He is what? Paralyzed. The nerve that is acting, that innervates that particular part of this body is what? Paralyzed. And if paralyzed, that part of the body cannot do what? Move. So apart from sensitivity, it also helps in what? In what? Locomotion and movements. Three of us. That's why we have sensory nerves and what? Motor words. Three of us. Now, let me not go deep. Are you appreciating what I'm trying to do now? I'm breaking this down, building up to the system where they belong. Now, we also have the epidermal cells. Epidermal cells. What are the epidermal cells? Epidermal cells, they are there to protect the body against infection, germs, and what? Dehydration. These epidermal cells in human body, they build up to the level of what? Epithelial what? Tissues. Even to the level of what? Skin. Is skin a nerve? Is skin a cell, tissue, or an organ? Good. Epithelial cell. Epidermal cells. Epithelial tissues. Coming down to what? Example. The skin. Favorite with us. Alright. So now apart from this type of cells, we also have another one called, we have the sperm cells. Sperm cell is also there. Even the egg cells, sperm cells, and what? Egg cells. Another name for egg cells is what? Ovum. Three of us. And sperm itself is a cell. So sperm cell and ovum. These cells now make up, sperm cells come together. Its function facilitate the function that what the tissue we call what? Testis. Is testis tissue or organ? Tissue. Are you sure? Is testis tissue or organ? What of ovum come up to what you call what? Ovaries. Three of us, ovary. Ovary, is it a tissue or an organ? It's a tissue. Have you now seen this whole thing come up to build up to what is called what? Reproductive what? They come up to reproductive organ. Which now come to what? Reproductive system. Reproductive organ for male is what? Reproductive organ for male is what? Is it penis? When you are drawing penis now, the different part of the penis, some tissues, there are different tissues there in that organ, three of us. each tissue having its own what function.
Now, testis is there for what? Sperm what? Production. True of us. There's one there for other things. But now, at the end of the whole thing, all these things come together to form the organ, which the organ now make up the what? Reproductive what? System.
I mean, I see how you started from cell, tissue, organ and what? System. Am I communicating?
Now, let us look into another one. Muscle cells. Muscle cells. We are still at a cell level. Muscle cells. Muscle cells helps in what? Movement and what? Locomotion.
Muscle cells help in what? Movement and what? Locomotion. But remember, without nerve cells, can they move? Can they move?
No. So muscle cells helps in what? Movement and locomotion. These muscle cells come together to form what is called what?
Muscle. Is muscle a tissue or an organ? It's a tissue, right?
Form what is called what? Muscle.
Are you there?
Now, the muscle plus other, the muscle and the skeletal tissues. Muscle is the tissue on its own.
Bone, tissue that make up the bone,
and the entire skeleton,
and the ligaments. And the ligaments that bind the what? Bind them
together to form the what is called skeletal system. Combined with muscle, all of them
come together to form a system we call what? Musculoskeletal system. Muscle and what? Skeletal what? System.
And this system helps in your what? Locomotion.
As you can see, the way I'm now moving around is musculoskeletal what?
Musculoskeletal system. Now, I made mention of bone cells. True or false? I talked about bone cells. How bone cells make up the bone as a tissue.
Bone cells make up the bone as a what? Tissue. And the tissue, the different bone tissue with the cartilage and ligaments
combined together, even with the endings, each of the muscles, most of them end with what is called tendon.
Tendon attached to the what? To the what? Bones, right? All this will come together to form this what? Musculoskeletal what? System. It's not amazing.
No, I am just dismantling this in animals. Now, then, apart from the movement, it also gives what? Support.
It gives what?
Support. Now, let's go over to tissue.
I have almost talked about everything, the two of us. Let me just define tissue.
Now, tissue can be defined as a collection. As a collection of similar cells.
Collection of similar cells.
Collection of similar cells that are similar in structure and what?
Function.
Collection of what?
Cells that are similar in what?
Structure and what? Function. That is what? Tissue. Now, which of the organisms stop at level of tissue? Which of the organism can we use as an example of organism that stop at level of tissue?
We have Hydra, or generally Coelenterates, true of us. Or let me just mention them. Use Hydra, not just the name of the class. Hydra is a typical example at the what? Tissue level.
And we also mention some tissues in the system, in the body. We have here, starting from plants. In plants, you have in plant we have xylem and vascular tissue. In plant we have what? Vascular what? Tissue.
implant, we have vascular what? Tissue. And this vascular tissue is made up of what? Xylem and what? Phloem. Xylem and what? Phloem. And the xylem is responsible for what? Conduction of what? Water and what? Nutrients. From the roots to where? To the what? Leaves. Why phloem is involved in what? Conduction of what? Manufactured food in the leaves to other parts of the what? Body of the plant, where they are stored. Now, this process of conduction of food, conveying food, manufactured food from the leaves to other parts of the body is called what? Translocation. It's called what? Translocation. Now, this is what this vascular tissue implants. This is what they do implant. Vascular what? Tissue. We don't have strengthening tissues. They are there to strengthen the plant and support the plant. Just as we have your skeletal musculoskeletal system or skeletal system for support in what? High animal. We also have what? Strengthening tissue or supporting tissue in plants. And that we have here what? We are what? Sclerenchyma, parenchyma, and collenchyma. Two of us. Now. Then we also have photosynthetic tissues. We have photosynthetic tissues involved in what? Photosynthesis. Example is what? Is leaf a tissue or another?
Tissue.
Is a tissue, right? Example is what? Tissue. And you know about different cells. We have mesophyllis there, two of us, specialized tissue there. We have mesophyll, veins, two of us, and the vein and what again? We have the mesophyll, vein, and what again? What other part of it? Mesophyll, vein, and what? Alright. Now, they are there for what? Manufacturing of what? Foods. Now, we also have the epithelial what? Tissue. Epithelial tissue, they are there and they line the surface of the what? Plant. Three of us. They are there to line and protect the plant what? Surfaces. Epithelial tissue. They line and protect the plant what? Surfaces. Now, we also have the packing tissues. Packing tissues are just there. They somehow provide. Do I say a seed, or they provide surface for younger cells to do what? Come out. Are you there? For younger cells to do what? Come out. Or for new cells to do what? Come out. Now, these are the examples of tissue. Which remember we talked about at tissue level we have hydra. Stop at this level. Then tissue in more cellular organism, in higher organism. Now, examples of tissue there we have here what? These ones I mentioned now. Vascular tissue, strengthening tissue, photosynthetic tissue, epithelial tissues, and what? Packing what? Tissues. Packing what? Tissues. Now, let's go to animals. Animal. Examples of tissues in animals are what and what? What are they? Give me example of tissues in animal. We also have here what? Epithelial tissue is also what? There. Epithelial tissue is also what? There. Two of us. Epithelial tissue is also what? There. Epithelial tissue is also what? There. Now, what are the functions of the epithelial tissues? They are there to line and protect the body surface, and they help in the formation of the what? Skin. We see. I think I mentioned this. They are there to in epithelial cells. It's epithelial cells that give us the what? Epithelial tissue. So they are there to line the skin. Now, the epithelial tissue now come together and form the what? Skin. Three of us. Good. Now, let's continue. We also have another type of tissue we found in animal, blood. Is blood a tissue or an organ? Blood is a tissue. The blood is made up of different cells. Blood is made up of what? Different what? Cells. Are you there? We have white blood cells. We have white blood cells. We also have what? Red blood cells. Even though their functions are somehow not exactly, they are not performing exactly the same function, but they are the cells of the what? Blood. So they are what? They are what? The blood tissue that is just there to transport what? Food and what? Oxygen. Food and what? Oxygen. Food and what? Oxygen. And also, can we confidently say that because of the white blood cells, can we also say that it also helps in what? It also helps in the protection. Protecting the body against what? Against diseases. Can we comfortably say that? Alright, let's continue. Now, another type of tissue, I have mentioned it, yes, is what? We have skeletal tissue. Skeletal what? Tissue. Skeletal what? Tissue. Skeletal what? Tissue. They are there to support the body and movement. Two of us. Skeletal tissue is composed of what? The bones. Bones, when you say skeletal tissue, now you talk about the bone, even cartilage is there. Two of us, bones are what? Cartilage, they are there. Two of us, they are there. Now, we have what? Connective tissues. When you talk about connective tissue, they are there to bind the other tissue together. As an example of connective tissue, that's when you have your what? Ligaments is there. Two of us, is tendon there too? Two of us is there. So, note all those points. Now we also have our what? Nerve tissue. I mentioned nerve tissue here before when I talked about nerve cells. When I talked about what? Nerve cells. I mentioned nerve tissue when I talked about what? Nerve cells. Now they are there to do what? Conduct what? Impulses. Transmit and conduct what? Impulses. They transmit and conduct nerve what? Impulses. Another one is what? Muscle tissue. I mentioned it when I talked about muscle cells. From there, I came down to muscle tissue. Now, muscle tissue, skeletal tissue, and connective tissue, these three types of tissue come together to form your what? Musculoskeletal what? System. Three of us. Good. Please note those points. Note those points. Am I complicating? Now, let's continue. Now, having talked about, this is all about what? Tissue what? Level. This is all about what? Tissue what? Level. Now, let us go to what? Organ level. Give me an example of representative organism that stopped at level of organ. Onion bulb is here. Onion bulb is here. Onion bulb is an organ. Three of us. Onion bulb is there. It stopped at this level. This onion used to cook is an organ. It stopped at this level. Onion bulb. Then what is an organ? What is an organ? What is an organ? An organ is a collection of different tissues. Listen carefully. He announced. We start having changes in the definition, so just listen carefully. An organ is a collection of different tissues with different what? Functions. Note that one, please. An organ is a collection of different tissues that perform different what? Functions. Now, there are different organs. Implants. Organ implant is what? Onion bulb. In animal, there are different organs in animal. There is a one-function organ, and there are multi-function organ. So, multi-function organ now. Multi-function organ now, because they have different tissues. Because they have what? Different tissues that perform different what? Functions. That's why the organ can be what? Multitask. The organ is now multi-what? Task. That means the organ can perform different functions.
Example of one function organ is what? Heart.
Yeah, it's only just there to pump,
nothing else. Now, but multifunction, multi-task organs like heart, kidney. Kidney does a lot of things. Liver does a lot of things. Because there are different tissues found in the kidney. There are also different tissues found in what? In the what? Liver. Each of these tissues has its own what? Function. But all of them come together to form. That's why the functions of the, if you start listing the functions of the kidney, is much. If you start listing the functions of the what? Liver, is much. These organs are very, very vital. That if anything happens to them, sorry is name. Sorry is what? The name. So, let's continue. Any question? Any question? No question. Let's continue. Now, let's go down to what? Organ system. You can call it organ system or simply what? Organ. Sorry, simply what? System. You can call it organ system or what? Simply what? System. Now, let me go back a bit. Now, in tissue, the tissue organs apart from hydra, we also have other organisms that stop at level of tissue. We have algae stop at level of tissue. Know that one. Fungi also stop at level of what? Tissue. Fungi also stop at the level of what? Tissue. Even sponges, other sponges stop at level of what? Tissue. Know that point, please. Then organism that stop at level of organ. I say something about onion bulb. Please, onion bulb is just an organ on its own. But organism, apart from that one, we have other organisms. We have fern, and what? Flatworms stop at level of what? Organ. Flatworms stop at level of what? Organ. Please note those points. So, fern stop at level of organ system. It's mosses. You know the difference between ferns and what? And what? Mosses. Fern. Mosses stop at level of what? Organ. Why fern stop at level of what? Organ system or system. Fern stop at level of organ system. That's plant. An example of an animal that stop at level of organ system is what? Mollusks, snails stop at level of what? Organ system. Now, example of animal that stop at level of organ is what? Example is what? Flatworms. Then mosses, yes. Then tissue, we have your hydra, algae, fungi, other cylindrates, and even what? Sponges. Cells, you have your what? Monera, protista, and what have you. Under protista, you have, under monera, you have your bacteria, blue algae them. Then under protista, you have your what? You have your what? Protozoa, amoeba, paramecium, and what? Protophyta. In your protophyta, that's when you start having all those chlamydomonas and what have you, but urina is either here or here. Now let's continue. Let us go down to what? Organ system. Let's go down to what? Organ system. What are these organ systems? Organ system consists of what? Consists of collection of what? Organs. Collection of different organs that performs a particular what? Function. Different organs that perform a particular what? Function. Collection of different organs that perform a particular what? Function. Example of what you see in organ. I have mentioned plant and animal that stop at that level. I mentioned what? Mollusca and what? In plants we have what? Fern. Alright, let's continue. Here now,
Let us look at this organ works system. Organ works system. Remember, we started from here. I have mentioned everything in this organ system. Remember, each cell I mentioned, I traced that cell down to what a particular works organ system. Let's start again. Nerve cells. Nerve cells, right? You trace nerve cells, come down, nerve tissues, come down to nervous system. Muscle cell. You trace it. When it comes to tissue, you bone cell, you trace it down to what tissue again? Connective tissues at this level. Three of them come together to form your what? Musculoskeletal what? System. Bone cells alone and cartilage form the what? Skeletal what? System. Three of us form the what? Skeletal system. But we call it musculoskeletal because they normally you rarely see only the skeletal system alone. Muscles are always a what? Attached. That's why we use the term musculoskeletal. Either musculoskeletal. Now let's continue. Then you have your heart. You have your blood cells come together to form blood tissue. Blood. At this level, it will stop. When it come here, it will stop. Then heart combine. You have your cardiovascular system. You have your what? Cardiovascular. Cardio meaning heart. Cardiovascular system. Am I communicating? Cardiovascular what? System. Now, is lung an organ or a tissue? Lungs. Organ. So now, lungs with its own cells inside tissue coming together to form what is called what? The lungs coming down to what is forming part of the what? Respiratory what? System. Three of us. Am I complicating? Now, even his nose, an organ for what? Breathing. But it also forms part of it anyway, in a way. Now, mouth. The mouth, from the mouth, there are a lot of tissues there. Tissue. Cells coming down to intestine, lot of tissue cells coming down to what the stomach, all those things come down to what is called what form the what digestive what system. Is liver part of the digestive system? Is it a complete or ancillary? Alright, now coming down to kidney, from the kidney, in fact, from outside, we have your what? Penis for the male through which that has the what? Urethra, right? Is it urethra or urethra? Which one? Where is urethra? Urethra from the penis come up. Urethra connects the what? Bladder and what? What does that connect the bladder and the kidney? Urethra is the one that leads for the male penis through which you can now urine can pass away, pass out through of us. Then urethra is one that connects the what? The bladder and what? Kidney, two of us. Now, all those things, both the kidney, and all the tissue, the area, all of them form what you call, and the bladder form what you call the what? Excretory what? System. Form what you call the what? Excretory what? System. Am I communicating?
Yes.
So, this is the what we see in what? Organ what? System. Now, organ system now, different systems now. Different system now, now build up to form what we call what? Complex multicellular what? Organism like you and I. Like you and me, not you and I, like us. Like you and me, not you and I. You and I is we. You and me, us. Like you and me forms complex multicellular organisms like you and me. So now, that's what we see. Have you not seen how complex and organized this whole thing is? This is levels of what? Organization. Levels of what? Organizations. Here now, at this level now, here we have mammals are here. Mammals are at this level. Mammals and flowering plants. Mammals are what? Flowering plants are at this level. Complex multicellular what? Organism. Mammals and flowering plants are at this level. Mammals and flowering plants are at this level. Am I communicating? Alright, let's continue. Now, this whole organization is a wonderful thing, but it has some advantages and what? Disadvantages. How complex the system is has a very wonderful advantage. It also has some what? Disadvantages. And what are these advantages? Now, because of how complex this level is now, you see that it gives rise to what? Specialization. Each one will face its own work and do its own work. Either each one will do its own work without affecting the work of the other one. Either. So that it gives rise to what? Specialization. And when there is specialization, it gives rise to what is called what? Division of labor. Mind your business. Respiratory system is doing your own. While our system is doing its own. Either. It's a wonderful thing. And with their division of labor, their what? Efficiency. Everything will just be going on smoothly. As you are now, as you are looking at me now, different systems that they are doing their work. Let me assume that you just finished it. The A system is busy doing its own work. The nervous system is busy doing its own thing. Because you are watching me now, you are trying to coordinate, you are trying to reason, he's doing his own work. Respiratory system, you are taking oxygen and bringing up for oxygen. Respiratory system is doing its own work. The vascular system, cardiovascular system is doing everything, all of them are happening at their own pace without affecting each other. Respiratory system will not say because I want to work, I will shut down the whole system. You stop. No, now we cannot survive that way. Then because the kidney is producing urine, you will not say, oh yeah, heart stop working, bam. Oh yeah, lung stop working, oh yeah, stay there. Because I want to produce urine now. Will it work? So each of them is doing their own work without what? Affecting what? The other. That's one thing about this complex system. Now, there are disadvantages. What are these disadvantages? Now, because even though they are on their own doing their own work independently, but they are not completely what? Independent. They depend on what? Each other. In complex, unlike, look up, unlike in this organism that exists on their own as cells, exists on their own as tissue, these ones that are complex, the cells, most of the function, the heart depend a lot on nervous system, three of us. If the nervous system stop working, it will affect the heart. Three of us. In as much as they don't disturb each other, but once heart problem, it will affect the other. The same way, if the vascular system is blocked, that supply blood to the brain will do what? Will lack blood. A problem will shock, will come up. Three of us, cerebrovascular work, accident will occur. Stroke will come in. Three of us. People have seen that even though they don't serve each other, but when one start having problem, because they are dependent, or they are not completely independent, they will start having issues. This one will start having issues. It will look like a cascade of what reaction. This one will start having issues. This one will start affecting the other one. That is one thing about, one disadvantage about this word, complex. That's one disadvantage about this word, complex. Now, another disadvantage is that in this complex organism now, there's what is called ratio of surface area to volume. As I am now, look at me. I am a complex organism. Look at me. Look at the volume I acquire. It's too small. Sorry, the volume I acquire is much, but the surface area is very, very low to compare with the volume. So the ratio of surface area, do you understand what I mean by surface area over volume? Now, unlike something like amoeba, that has the surface area is much, right? Right? But the volume is where the entire system or entire organism, the space it occupies, right? The space it occupies. If you check those ones, the surface area is higher to compare with the space they do what? Occupy. So the ratio of surface area to volume is high. Because it's high, there is no much system. They don't need much. Maybe they're taking either oxygen or nutrients. They don't need extra system to take it around the entire body. It will just enter and do what spread without any problem. But here now, because of the, as it's entering through, this surface area is much. As it's entering through here, it's entering through here at the same time. Entering here at the same time. But with the complex human being, complex organism, with large volume, occupied volume, with small surface area. Surface area is the area of the system that is exposed. It's at any point in time, if you face here, the area exposed is small. Because of the nature of how complex our system is. Most of the things are inside, stocked in. The others are stocked in. The different organs and systems are stocked in different parts of the body. They are not exposed. So the surface area is smaller to compare with the volume. So that means the area, the ratio of surface area to volume is small. Because of that now, we need this complex organism, need special system to transport either nutrients or gases or oxygen as case may be to other parts of the body. So extra system is needed to circulate. That's why human beings and complex organisms have circulatory system. Why those small ones like amoeba, they are all these small ones, their surface area is the area is much to compare with the volume they occupy. They don't have much. They don't need those system to say they don't need circulatory system. That's why complex organisms have circulatory system to reach to those places that is only be difficult to reach. But those ones, they don't have what such a system. Have you not seen a disadvantage it can cause? Then another one is that because of the complex nature of this organism, because of the complex nature of this multicellular organisms, what happened is that there is tendency for there to be wear and tear. these organs in the body can break down. Two of us, because they keep the heart is busy pumping, always pumping to meet up with the need. Are you there? The heart is always pumping to meet up with the need. The liver is always metabolizing, always working all the time to meet up. Two of us, the lungs is there working its own to meet up. That's why you should be careful about what you're taking, because these organs, these vital organs on their own are passing through a loss. Then we go and start smoking, drinking alcohol, causing more harm to them. Have you not seen where they break down easily? Normal said to serve, to meet up with the need of the entire human system or organism is a serious work for them to do. They can break down easily. Then we human beings, we go and even compound our problem. We keep drinking until you see you eat, until you see you drink. They'll tell you that this one cure this one, concussion, you drink. You are killing the kidney, you are killing the liver, the more. Adding more trouble to their what? Trouble. So, because of the complex nature of most of these organisms, you don't realize that these things, they can easily break down from wear and tear, trying to meet up with the need to serve the entire world system. To serve the world, entire world system. And that point is that because of the complex nature of these organisms, because of the complex nature of this organism, you need to struggle enough to have enough food and enough oxygen. Because that's why, remember, the blood carries what? Nutrients, which is food, and what? Oxygen. Two of them must go together, because oxygen will help to break down those nutrients at the cellular level to release what? Energy in the form of ATP. And this energy release is what the system is used to drive most. Even this blinking of your eyes is possible because of energy release from what? Cellular what? Respiration. Even movement of your body is one of the energy released. Without that, the cells cannot work. The mitochondria is there doing that job. Am I communicating? Mitochondria is a powerhouse of the cell. Is an organelle. Is there doing that, breaking down this, is where the cellular respiration takes place. It's working too far to release this energy, which the cell needs. Remember what I told you guys sometime in the past, that we should learn how to feed our what? Cells, and not to feed our what? Stomach. You may feed your stomach and your cell will be dying. And when your cell has issues, that's the end. Because everything boils down to what? Cells. Cell is the building block. When the foundation has issues, what happens? It has to do what? Collapse. So when the cells have issues, the entire system will do what? Shut down. Am I communicating? So I have the final seen, because of the complex nature of the body, the organism will strive to have enough food and what? Oxygen that will help to do what? Releasing energy required for the what? Maintaining that complex nature. Am I communicating? Any question? Any question? We are done with levels of organization of life, levels of organization. Any question? Any question? All right. In the absence of any question, we'll stop here for today. Thank you very much for your attention. See you next time.
Thank you for watching our online lectures. For lecture updates, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. The name is Susan Limited. Just click on the red button and click on the bell by the side so that you'll be among the first people to receive notification whenever we upload a new video. Please like and follow us on Facebook. The name is Susan Limited. If you have any question, please connect with us on WhatsApp. These are our WhatsApp numbers. Please visit our website. The address is susanlimited.com. You have a lot to learn. please share this video, like and comment. Thank you for your support. God bless you.
Admission. 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 Dear ladies and gentlemen, I bring good news. Admission into the diocese on the Niger School of Pharmacy Technician EENU Mission Hospital is on. The School of Pharmacy Technician, PHT, is an accredited tertiary institution that offers students a diploma degree to work in hospitals and pharmaceutical companies in order to promote safe and effective use of medicines at grassroots level. Graduates of Pharmacy Technician School EENU who wish to study pharmacy in the university can obtain direct entry into any university of their choice. The school has a well-equipped laboratory, comfortable hostel, and a healthy refectory. The requirements for admission are credit in English, mathematics, biology, chemistry and physics. In GCE, WAEC, NECO, NABTEB are not more than two sittings. The School of Pharmacy Technician, PHT, is located at EENU Mission Hospital, Agidi, Anambra State. For more information, call 0803-708-1512, 0813-868-2003, 0803-267-5322. Diocese on the Niger School of Pharmacy Technician. A tradition of excellence.